Welcome to the Duke of the Bump 200th video extravaganza. That's right, this is my 200th video uploaded to YouTube. It's not my 200th Let's Play, because I've uploaded some, some other stuff. There's the Lost Viking montages, and I uploaded a couple clips from cartoons occasionally, but, 200 videos uploaded is a pretty big milestone, and I'm going to celebrate by playing Taz, as you've never seen him before, successfully completing the Haunted Castle level. Okay, so maybe it's not that much of an extravaganza. I tried to think of something special that I could do to celebrate the milestone, but really, what I see as the bigger milestone is the fact that I actually have 500 subscribers now, which I think is more amazing than, pumping out 200 of these. I mean, these are easy. But man, there's half of 1,000 people in this world who are interested in watching me play video games. And, I mean, that fact just blows me away. 500 people. That's more people than were in my graduating class, I think. Ha! Shows you high school. So you may be wondering where I've been for the past couple weeks. Fact is, I am incredibly susceptible to LPR's burnout. This is a phenomenon that you may have heard of. Other people get it occasionally, I seem to get it a lot. You see, I was never really much of a talker. And one of the reasons I started doing these was to try to work on my speaking skills. And I think I've done a pretty good job. But I'm still... I don't really talk to people a lot in my day-to-day life. except for work, obviously, since I'm in tech support and I'm on the phones. Which, when I'm on the phone all day, it just makes me want to do LPs even less when I get home. Because, that's just more talking. My voice tends to, get strained after I do a lot of that, but I'm just making excuses now. I apologize for the delays in videos, but, I think that quality is more important than quantity, and if I tried to do videos when I wasn't, I wasn't feeling it, I wasn't, in the mood. Oh my god, a fucking checkpoint. It's a miracle. But yeah, if I tried to do LPs when I wasn't feeling it, then, the quality would just suffer. And I don't want that to happen. I don't want to hem and haw my way through the commentary and stammer and mutter and not really have anything to say. Alright, I have one more life to see if I can pull this off. And I don't have any gasoline now, so that's going to make getting through here even more tricky. Don't worry, I'll be updating Dungeon Hack 2. I just wanted to get Taz out of the way first, because this is quite possibly the most frustrating LP experience I've had since Splatterhouse 2. I forgot how incredibly difficult these last couple levels really were. And now I don't know where I need to go. I like that medical kit up there. Is there any way I can get to it? Probably not. Here's a sandwich. Sandwiches are pretty cool. They're not as good as medical kits, but, you know. Okay, I can jump through that platform. That's pretty good. I'm gonna lose more life trying to get it than it would freaking give me. Lovely. Wow, another checkpoint. That's amazing. I totally want to, you know, play more of this level. And I still have a boss to deal with after this too. I'm gonna have to make it through the last part of this level and beat the boss on zero lives. Where do I go? Okay. Something tells me I'm gonna have to start over again. The hell was that sound? Oh, Jesus. This is such bullshit. These platforms are timed exactly so that it's impossible to jump from one to the next. It's impossible. Okay. It's not impossible. It's just way too difficult. Now that fly is probably going to knock me back off. Please let me be close to the end. Oh my god. Oh my god, I made it. I fucking made it. You know what? I don't care. I'm going to save state. That's right. Duke of the Mom, for the first time since Splatterhouse 2, is resorting to using save states. Because I don't remember how hard this boss is. Okay, what do I have to do? Okay, I have to stand on this platform, and then pull that switch. Okay. But of course, he doesn't always stop where the electric chair is. I don't get it. I don't get it at all. How am I supposed to do that? Maybe it'll let me continue from the boss. Please? Nope. Oh well, cheating time. Maybe I have to do something to myself. Maybe it doesn't electrocute me. Maybe it makes me bigger or something. No. It doesn't do anything to me. Okay, so I have to catch the monster in it somehow. How do I do that? I mean, I can't do anything to the boss directly. So I have to dodge the monster, dodge the freaking electricity laser. What the fuck? I don't get it. I don't know how this is possible. I mean, how would I get him to stand there? I'll see you next time on Taz and Escape from Mars. Bye, everyone.